to visit me?
Sure.
Why?
Because I kind of like you.
You do?
Yeah. You're pushy and you're stubborn. And you bug me a little. I like that in a person.
What's so funny?
She thought we were married.
Why?
Because we fight so well.
You don't understand, lady. See, we fight because he bugs me. He'd be a nice guy if he didn't give me such a hard time, but he always bugs me. You understand?
I gotta go shower.
Oh, no, you don't. I need the bathroom. I have to wash my hair, and you know it takes me 3 hours. 3 hours? Blair, they sandblast Mount Rushmore in less time than that.
Wait a second. Okay, get ugly.
What?
Come on, fight.
What are you talking about?
I want to get one of your arguments on tape. That way, when we get lonesome, we can just play it back.
That's a great idea. Once a month, Nat and I will pop popcorn, look at my pictures, and listen to the tape. It'll be like you're still here.
What are you, nuts?
Good, that's good, but say it to her. And then call her Airbrain. And then you call her Gladys Goodwrench, and we're off.
Natalie, our arguments are inspired. They're works of art. You can't just pull them out of thin air.
Yeah, you gotta yank them right out of your gut.
I see. Well, if you feel something coming, just press this button and scream into this, okay? I'm throwing out the first Oreo. Who wants it?
I do. I want it.
We'll split it.
I suppose you want the side with the cream.
Guys, relax. I got a whole bag.
I've owed myself this facial for a month. There's nothing like a good mask to flush out your pores.
Just don't flake into the pretzels. Oh, this is it. Apocalypse now. I knew it couldn't last. I wasn't meant to have money.
Now, Joe.
And you. You and your compact limos. A sure winner, you said.
I did?
Unleaded luxury, you said.
I did?
The stock of the 80s, you said.
Why did you listen? I'm not E.F. Hutton.
It's all over.
What do you mean?
I've got nothing thanks to you.
You're not thinking of doing anything silly now, are you?
No. Murder is serious business.
Is she in here?
Who?
Joe.
No.
Oh, thank goodness.
Don't worry. I'm all right now. I decided to sell my stock.
Oh, good.
If he did think you were perfect, would you have gotten so crazy?
I don't know. But if I'm not perfect, and that's a big if. Certainly wasn't his place to say so.
Right? It's my place.
I wouldn't miss this for the world. Our Joe eating with royalty.
Blair, small comment before they get here.
Sure.
One snicker and you're dead meat.
Naturally. Joe. Everything is gonna be all right. I'll just make one little call to that foundation and you'll get the scholarship.
Blair.
You don't want the scholarship?
Not if you come with it.
Will you two knock it off? Now we've already lost 2 hours because of Tootie and Natalie.
Good. I'm losing a bolt. I'm working at half wattage.
judge. I'll ask her to give him a call.
Okay, you contact your mother. I'll try Geraldo.
All right.
I am not going in there alone with him. Come with me.
Remember, you owe me one.
It must feel good to get a clean bill of health.
Uh-huh. Well, the only thing I...
It's up. My stock is up. I can't believe it. Just think, my mom never has to wait another table. And she's never seen Switzerland.
Joe, it's up a quarter point. Hold off on the yodeling lessons.
Blair, thank you. How can I thank you? You're a genius.
Finally. She's talking sense.
This stock market thing is the greatest. Do people know about this?
Now you can introduce us to older men.
No, 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 Natalie. The best thing is no more kitchen duty.
Yeah.
An effective lighting is created by the large opening.
Did you buy what I told you to buy?
I sure did. I now own a full share of Kramer's Compact Limo Company.
Compact limos?
Right. Blair said that the rich are cutting back. Compact limos save on gas.
I did.
She said it's a sure winner.
I did.
And she said she'd pay me if it drops.
I did not. Just to keep in shape. The English lit teacher at Bates.
I think that's nice. Mrs. Garrett needs a little companionship.
Well,
no kidding. How are you able to keep going like that?
Well, he certainly is dynamic.
Oh.
Hi, Natalie.
Well, you ready?
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Chad, good.
Hi, Chad.
A beautiful woman who's prompt? What more could a man want?
Chad!
Oh, hi, ladies.
Hi. Hi, Chad.
Fuck this shit, I'm out.
I never knew there was so much wrong with me until Chad.
Maybe there wasn't until Chad.
I mean, before, we were worried.
Would you like to go?
Yeah, sounds good. When is it?
Thursday night. Not this Thursday, a week from Thursday. And I won't wear this blouse.
Gee, it's hard for me to make plans that far in advance.
I tell you what, why don't you just say maybe, and if something better comes up, you can always change your maybe to a no, and I'll understand.
You're terrific. Mm-hmm. Look, I'll talk to you later.
Okay.
He can change his maybe to a no, and you'll understand?
I thought the maybe would get him a magic marker up the nose.
Please, I'm lucky he didn't say no. I was afraid to even ask him. I hope he has nothing better to do.
Blair, where have you been?
In class with me. At least her body was there. I can't account for her mind.
I know. He didn't call.
And thank goodness! Who needs a guy that takes you to a party and leaves with somebody else?
There must be a perfectly good explanation for what he did.
Sure there is. He just hasn't thought of it yet.
Blair. Chad did call. Chad and his friends are going skiing to Vermont tomorrow. If you want to go, call him before 7 in the morning.
Hold it, Warner.
Joe, I'm getting another chance. What?
Please, don't go on that trip with him.
I'll call him and tell him no.
Wrong. You don't call him at all. You don't even talk to him.
Right. You have to go cold turkey.
Well, I gotta get going anyway. Oh, listen, Joe, would you mind terribly finishing up the pots for me today so I can meet Steve a little early for lunch?
Sorry, Blair. I'm not doing extra chores again. You're gonna have to tell your friend to order the blue plate special for one. Okay, this is the last time.
Oh, thanks a lot, Joe.
We'll do anything we have to do to keep your mind off of him. Anything.
Nobody's ever gonna believe this. I gotta get it on film.
Making Joe over was a wonderful idea. Thank you, Natalie.
Yeah, thank you, Natalie.
Joe, your face is like a hunk of wet clay. I can just sink my fingers into it and sculpt it into anything I want.
Can we take it easy here, Blair? We're not making a meatloaf.
No, you look darling. I bet you look great with short hair. It's really in now.
Joe, wake up. We can go to sleep now. It's 7:22. It's 7:22. He's gone to Vermont. You're in the clear.
We made it. We made it.
Yeah, hello.
Chin of gold a night or two ago, and now she turns her perfect face upon the world below. The moon, Emily Dickinson.
It's freezing, Joe Polniaczek.
Joe, you can't let the most beautiful night of the year go to waste.
I am not sleeping 2 feet away from an open window. I don't need a cold right now.
You don't catch colds from open windows.
Not if you close them.
All right, then, let's switch beds.
I don't want to sleep in your bed.
Joe, please. I need the moon's caress.
Oh, all right. We'll switch beds.
Thank you.
No!
Returning ever so smoothly to my welcoming fingers.
We'll do fine.
Didn't you see any of that?
Any what?
All right, Polniaczek. Stand back and eat my smoke. Ready?
Go crazy.
Around the world. Hit the dirt!
What?
You're tickling my feet.
How could I? I'm way over here.
You know, Blair, I have to hand it to you. You're taking your first dateless Saturday night very well.
It's not Saturday night. It's Thursday night.
What?
Tootie, play along with her. It's the only way she can handle this.
Why didn't I leave with Joe? I could have had a perfectly safe ride on the back of her filthy bike. I think I'll take my hot chocolate upstairs. My feet are cold.
Me too.
Wait up, Blair. I'll go with you.
Joe, how sweet. But really, I'm feeling much better now.
I want the blanket for my broccoli. Hey, I'm taking off for home, Mrs. G.
Okay.
Guess what, Joe? I got into Langley.
Hey, congratulations. Guess I'm gonna have to stop calling you Airbrain.
I opened a charge account at the Langley College bookstore.
Langley? You going there? I hear it's a terrific school.
This is true. Unfortunately, their practice has been to take only one gifted student from each prep school. This year, it happened to be moi.
Haven't they ever taken two?
You know, Blair, this sweatshirt looks like it's just my size. You mind if I keep it? You do have four.
Joe, Joe, Joe. You know I'm generous to a fault. But don't you think it would be a better idea to wait and wear one from your own school?
Oh, didn't I tell you? Langley is my school. See you around campus.
That's great!
Graduation is traditionally a time of looking forward. Let us consider a moment how we arrived at this moment. None of us did this alone. You've received support in the hard times. Encouragement when we needed it. Most important, love from our family and friends. All this leaves us with a debt that cannot be measured or repaid.
Joe?
What?
How's it going?
Okay.
Joe. I'm gonna make some coffee. You want some coffee?
No, thanks.
Joe.
What?
Nothing. Forget it.
All right, what?
I'm scared.
Blair, you're gonna do fine.
Not about the exams, about what happens next.
What do you mean? You're the one who's always talking about getting out into the world.
Well, it seemed like a good idea at the time.
So what happened?
Nothing. Just forget it. You don't want to hear about this.
I'm listening.
I went to a lot of schools before I came to Eastland. I'd usually stick around a couple of months, till Christmas. Then I'd call my mom, tell her I was miserable, and she'd move me somewhere else. I was at Eastland a whole year before I realized I hadn't even called. When June rolls around, you'll be leaving school. I'll be leaving home.
Blair, if I had to pick one person I knew was gonna love college, it'd be you.
Would, huh?
Sure. You're the girl on front of the brochure with the knee socks on the books, smiling at the future. Come on, it's normal to be scared. A lot of people are.
Are you?
A little. See, when you go to Langley, you're taking yourself. I'm bringing along my mom, my dad, the whole neighborhood. They're all counting on me. See, where I come from, nobody goes to college. Closest we ever got was Susie Schufo. She got into the Rockettes.
If I had to name one person I knew was going to make it at college, it would be you.
No, I don't know. It's a big change.
And you can get used to anything.
Yeah?
You got used to me, didn't you?
Well. Look, I'm sorry I hit you. I hope you're all right.
I'm fine. Wasn't that good a shot?
Well, I want you to know I'm never gonna hit you again.
Good. Because it wasn't that bad a shot either.
Thanks. It's not gonna be easy when Meg goes. I don't want to lose all these feelings I have. I don't want it all to disappear.
It won't.
How do you know?
I just know.
Well, you got me mad.
So what else is new? You always make me mad. You make me furious.
Well, then why did you do this for me?
Because I didn't want you to go. I can admit we're friends even if you can't.
I can admit it.
Well, that's what friendship is, Joe. I do something for you.
And I do something for you.
No. I do something for you. And you let me do it.
But then I owe you. Don't I?
You owe the gas company. You owe Bloomingdale's. You don't owe your friends. You just get through things together.